Hearing before the Parliamentary Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises COSASE, were officials of Uganda Investment Authority led by the Executive Director Robert Mokiza. The committee, which is scrutinizing the Auditor General's report for the financial year that ended June 2023, probed Uganda Investment Authority officials on the owners of the two private industrial parks in Imbale and Kapeka, on which government has been spending taxpayers' money.
These private industrial parks where you support infrastructure services.
Those are the two that we have now, Imbale and Kapeka Industrial Park.
Who owns Kapeka Industrial Park?
Sorry?
Who owns the one in Kapeka?
Kapeka Industrial Park is owned by private individuals.
Called who? Who are those?
I will supply.
I want to look at, and then the one of Mbale.
Mbale again is owned by Mr. Paul Zhang, who is a private industrial park.
You give us,
and we'll give you the ownership of the
whole park. But when it came to Kapeka, I don't know whether it's because of the person which we say he's not that. I just said I will provide.
Don't worry.
But having said that,
Murife cannot run.
Committee members led by the chairperson Medad Segona sounded cautions to the Uganda Investment Authority for abandoning of infrastructure, especially roads around the industrial parks, which have been ravaged by heavy trucks that access industrial parks. They pointed at Semuto Kapeka, which is in tatters, yet it's used by trucks ferrying raw materials to Kapeka Industrial Park.
The infrastructure have been destroyed around these industrial parks. For instance, the Namukeke line in Kapeka, the road from Matuka, exactly where this industrial park is, the road has been washed away, has been destroyed.
Look at the level of destruction by your trucks going to your industrial parks vis-a-vis the results and returns, especially after literally giving away all that we expect to get from these investors, apart from the petty jobs. Does that not call for a review of our investment policy?
During the interface, it emerged that the entity is operating without an investment policy to guide its operations.
But a policy describes the relationships with those who don't report to you and with the public. And how do people get those facilities? It is a policy. So if we don't have a policy, as a member of parliament, how do I relate with you? How do I advocate for an industrial park in my place?
You develop a policy, send it to the ministry. We have a minister, and specifically the docket of the minister is investment. And how many years are these? 5 years? Here is the gateway to Koboko, really. She will tell us.
An investment policy describes the parameters for investigating government funds and identifies the investment objectives, preference or tolerance of risk, constraints on the investment portfolio, and how the investment program will be managed and monitored. Uganda Investment Authority explained that the investment policy was enacted in 2018, but it is catching dust in the Ministry of Finance, which is mandated to approve it.
Policy in place, the draft investment policy, which has not been launched by Minister of Finance, but it is with Minister of Finance. So the draft.
When did you start drafting it?
We developed it in 2018.
Yes, that now the draft policy is in the with the minister. How consultative was it? Can you give us a draft copy? Because some institute agencies come here and they say there is something in the kitchen, yet it is nothing. Can you give us that draft as a proof that you sent to the ministry?
The committee vowed to summon the Minister of State for Investment, Evelyn Anite, to explain the stalled approval of the investment policy. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.